That is.
Did you pause it? Okay, you can start now. You give me a count again. Three. Wait, it's not red, wait.
Was it on it? Was it red?
You have come, but you are not on red.
Good afternoon, boys and girls. Once again, welcome to grade 6 class. My name is Mr. Darius Daka, taking you through our topic for today. So in our today's lesson, we are going to look at how the Bemba used to live, how the Bemba used to live in the past. But before we look at today's lesson, boys and girls, I want to take you through what we learned last time. Okay, so if at all you've got any SMSs that you want to send, or if you have got any questions, you can MS me on 0970703139. You can SMS me on 0970703139. Once you SMS me using that line, I'll be able to respond to your SMSs. Okay, so you must also understand that our GMF online classes are running on Facebook. So if you want to be part and parcel of the GMF classes, you can participate by contacting the numbers that are scrolling on your screen. Okay, so you can contact the numbers that are scrolling on your screen, that is for grade 8, grade 10, and grade 11 classes. Okay, so boys and girls, last time we looked at how the Bantu people used to live. But before we did that, we also looked at how the Sun people used to live. They said that the Sun people were hunter-gatherers, okay? These were hunter-gatherers, meaning that they used to hunt wild animals for food. They could hunt animals such as antelope, impalas, and others for food, okay? So they were also wild gatherers, okay? They were also wild gatherers, meaning that they used to gather wild food such as fruits and vegetables for food. Okay, so again, we looked at how the Bantu speaking people used to live. We say that the Sun people used to live in caves. They lived in caves. Okay, so when the Bantu people came from the west, they chased the Sun people from Zambia. When the Bantu people came from the west, they chased away the Sun people. So where do we find the Sun people today, boys and girls? We find the Sun people in the Kalahari and Namib deserts. We find the Sun people in the Kalahari and Namib deserts. So we say that the Bantu speaking people settled in Zaire. Okay, they settled in Zaire, which is the former name for Congo DR. Once they settled in Zaire, they formed two kingdoms. They formed two kingdoms, and these are the Luva and the Lunda Kingdom. They formed two kingdoms, which are the Luva and the Lunda Kingdom. So we say also that the first people to arrive in Zambia were the Tonga speaking people. These were the earliest people who came into Zambia, and they settled on the southern part of Zambia. Okay, so other tribes followed later on. So this is what we looked at in our last lesson, boys and girls. So in our today's lesson, we are going to look at how the Bemba people used to live. Okay. So, boys and girls, the coming in of the Bemba speaking people brought in a new technology compared to the Sun speaking people. Why? Because the Bemba speaking people were part of the Bantu speaking people who brought in new technology such as the use of iron tools. They brought in the use of iron tools. Okay, so the Bemba moved from Niger in West Africa to the Congo and on to the northern section of Zambia. They came from West Africa into the Congo and then they moved into the northern part of Zambia. So some of them, they settled in a northern province, others they settled in Luapula province, others they settled in Copper Belt, others Muchinga and eastern provinces of Zambia. So boys and girls, you must understand that the Bemba speaking people were the biggest ethnic group that we had among the Bantu speaking people. These were the biggest ethnic group that we had among the Bantu speaking people. So we can say the Bembas were the biggest ethnic group among the Bantu speaking people. So boys and girls, Bembas were the biggest ethnic group among the Bantu speaking people. They were the biggest ethnic group among the Bantu speaking people. So again, I said that they settled in northern Luapula eastern So they settled in northern Luapula, eastern, and Muchinga provinces. So they settled in northern Luapula and Muchinga. They settled in northern Luapula, eastern, and Muchinga provinces. So these are the provinces where the Bantu speaking people, where the Bemba speaking people settled. Okay, so let's look at how the Bembas used to live. Okay, so let's look at their social life. How was their social life? Okay, how did they relate socially? Okay, how did they relate socially? So when you talk about their social life, we are referring to how they were interacting socially with other people. Okay, so unlike the Khoisan people who existed in Zambia, so you must understand that the Khoisan were also the San speaking people. Okay, so unlike the Khoisan people who existed in Zambia before, the Bemba were well organized with one paramount chief. So these were well organized. So they were well organized with one paramount chief. Okay, so they were well organized with one paramount chief. Boys and girls, who is the paramount chief of the Bemba speaking people? If you have the name for the Bemba speaking people, you can text me so that I know whether you know the name for the paramount chief of the Bemba speaking people. So these people had one paramount chief. Okay, they had one paramount chief. So the Bembas settled in one place and developed farming villages. So they settled in one place. They settled in one place. And developed farming villages. So they settled in one place and developed farming, family villages. Also, unlike the San people who lived in caves, the Bema speaking people were well organized. Why? Because they developed family villages. They developed family villages where they could settle. Okay, so this is how the Bema speaking people used to live. Okay, so family inheritance was through the mother's side of the family. Okay, family inheritance was through the mother's side of the family. So boys and girls, when I say family inheritance was through the mother's side of the family, what does it mean? Okay, in most what it means here is that the mother's side was more powerful or more stronger when it came to family inheritance compared to the father's side. Okay, so for example, when it comes to getting of the children, okay, for example, if there was a divorce between a husband and the wife, it means that the wife could get the children and take them to their mother's side. Okay, so this kind of family is called matrilineal system. This kind of family is called matrilineal system. So, boys and girls, when we say this kind of family is called matrilineal system, what does the word matrilineal mean? It means that the inheritance belonged to the mother's side of the family. The inheritance, whatever the father inherited or whatever they inherited, both of them, it belonged to the mother. Okay, so the mother got all the inheritance. Okay, whatever they acquired, the mother was the one who got those things. Okay, so that is what is known matrilineal system. All right, so let's move on, boys and girls. Let's look at the their economic way of life. Okay, so let's talk of their economic way of life. Okay, so when you talk of economic way of life, what does it mean? Economy simply means trade. Okay, how did these people sell their goods? Okay, what did they use to make in order for them to sell? That's what it means when you talk about economic way of life. So the Bema brought with them advanced Iron Age skills. So they brought advanced Iron Age skills. They brought advanced Iron Age skills. They brought advanced Iron Age skills, such as making pottery, the ability to make many types of pigments and dyes as coloring. Okay, so they could make pottery. Okay, so they could color clothes. Okay, they could color clothes. Using dyes. Okay, they could color clothes using dyes. Okay, so they make the ability to make many types of pigments and dyes as coloring. They could also weave. Okay, they could also weave. So there we can write cotton weaving. They could also weave using cotton. They could also weave using cotton. And then there was also ivory carving and metalwork. There was also ivory carving and metalwork. Okay, so this is what the Bantu, the Bemba people used to do in order for them to survive economically. This is what the Bemba people used to do in order for them to survive economically. Okay, so once again, boys and girls, if you have any question, you can SMS me on 0970703139. You can SMS me on 0970703139. Okay, so you must also understand that the GMF online classes are running, okay, on Facebook, so you can contact the lines that are scrolling on your screen. You can contact the lines that are scrolling on your screen in order for you to be part and parcel of the GMF classes. Okay, so boys and girls, let's continue with what we are looking at. Okay, so let's look at their cultural life. Okay, we look at their cultural life. Okay, in terms of culture, what did the Bemba people do? Okay, in terms of culture, what did they do? So there is no initiation ceremony for Bemba boys. Okay, there is no initiation ceremony for Bemba boys. Okay, there is no initiation ceremony for Bemba boys. Okay, so girls go through an initiation ceremony called Chisungu. Okay, girls go through an initiation ceremony called Chisungu. Okay, they go through an initiation ceremony called Chisungu. Okay, so what happens when time for this initiation ceremony takes place? What happens is that teenagers who are girls, they are taken into a secret place, such as a house. Okay, so in that house, they are taught different things about life. Okay, especially the mothers are taught, they teach the teenagers different things about life. Okay, so they are taught on how to take care of their future husbands. They are taught on how to take care of the relatives from both the man's side and the woman's side. They are taught different things in this initiation ceremony. All right, so they are taught different things in that initiation ceremony. So this happens when girls become teenagers. The girls are taught the duties of cook, gardener, hostess, and mother. Okay, so during the initiation ceremony, there is much drumming, dancing, singing, and drama. So during the ceremony, there is much dancing, drumming, and drinking. Okay, so during the ceremony there is much dancing, drumming and drinking. Okay, sorry, there's much dancing, drumming, singing and drama. Okay, so this is what happens during the initiation ceremony called Chisungu. There's much dancing, drumming, singing, and drama. In short, girls are taught on how to cook, they are taught on how to take care of their husbands, they are taught on how to take care of relatives during the initiation ceremony. Okay, so let me check, boys and girls, if one or two people have found the answer for the Bemba speaking people. Okay, unfortunately there's no one. So the chief for the Bemba speaking people, boys and girls, is called Chitimukulu. Okay, the chief is called Chitimukulu. All right, I believe while you're copying that side, let me rub this side so that I can create enough space. All right, so boys and girls, let's look at their political life, okay? Their political life. The political life for the Bemba people. So how did they live politically? How did they live politically? Okay, so the village is where all political decisions were made. The village is where all political decisions were made, okay? So the village is where all political decisions were made. Okay, so all the decisions when it comes to their political life, they were made in the village. Okay, so they created a loosely united government. At its head was the paramount chief known as Chitimukulu. So the head of this government was called Chitimukulu. Okay, the head of the government was called Chitimukulu. Chitimukulu means the great tree. Chitimukulu means the great tree. So he was in charge of all the decisions that were going on in the village. He was in charge of all the decisions that were going on in the village. So the head of the government was called Chitimukulu, or the great tree. And he was served by sub-chiefs belonging to the royal crocodile clan. So he was served by sub-chiefs belonging to the royal crocodile clan. He was served by sub-chiefs belonging to the royal crocodile clan. Okay, he was served by sub-chiefs belonging to the Royal Crocodile clan. Okay, so the area of the Bemba's state was, the area of the Bemba state was divided into political districts, usually containing five or more villages. So the Bemba state was divided into political districts, usually containing five or more villages. So that's it about the Bemba speaking people. All right, so let's just go through what we've learned today about the Bemba speaking people in case you've forgotten some of the points. So earlier on I said that the Bemba speaking people came from West Africa, that is in the that is in Niger in West Africa, and they settled in Congo. Then from there they moved into Northern Province, Luapula, Copper Belt, Muchinga, and Eastern Provinces. So they moved into Northern, Luapula, Copper Belt, and Eastern Provinces. Okay, so we say that unlike the Khoisan or the Sun-speaking people, the Bembas were used iron to make tools. Okay, they used iron to make tools for farming and other things. Okay, so they made tools out of iron. So again, we say that the Bemba people were good at making pottery. Okay, they were good at pottery. Okay, so when you talk of pottery, this is where you use clay soil to make pots and other stuff. Okay, so they were good at pottery. Okay, so they could also color clothes using dyes. Okay, so they were also good at cotton weaving. The Bemba people were also good at ivory carving and metalwork. They were good at ivory carving and metalwork. All right. So that is about their economic way of life. So boys and girls, let's look at their cultural way of life. I said that there is no initiation ceremony for the Bemba boys. But girls go through an initiation ceremony called Chisungu. Okay, so during this ceremony, they are taught on how to take care of their husbands, they are taught on how to cook, they are taught on how to take care of the relatives and so on. Okay, so during the ceremony, there is much dancing, drumming, singing, and drama. Okay, so let's look at their political life. Okay, so the village is where all political decisions were made. So all the political decisions were made at the village. Okay, and then the head of the government was called Chitimukulu. Even up to this day, the paramount chief of the Bemba speaking people is called Chitimukulu. Chitimukulu means the great tree. He was served by sub chiefs belonging to the Royal Crocodile clan. So that's the lesson, boys and girls, on how the Bemba people used to live. Okay, that's the lesson on how the Bemba people used to live. So let me check if at all there are SMSs that have come through today. Okay, so for today, boys and girls, we don't have any SMSs. All right, so like I said at the beginning of my lesson, okay, if you have any you have got questions, you can SMS on 0970703139. We have got GMF online classes running. Okay, so you can contact the lines that are scrolling on your screen for GMF online classes, that is Goka Mubuyu and Fountain Gate classes on Facebook, in order for you to be part and parcel of those classes. Okay, so for me, it has been Mr. Darius Dakar. Until we meet next time, it's goodbye.
Good afternoon, class. examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the life.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the life.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
afternoon, class. And these are examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Good afternoon, class. I'm Mrs. Annie Kantoma, grade 6 teacher. I'm taking you through in integrated science, plants and animals. Before I go any further, let's talk about what we did last time that we had science. We looked at transpiration. We defined what transpiration is. And also looked at the factors that cause transpiration, which is light, temperature, humidity, and groundwater. Okay, today's lesson, boys and girls, we're going to look at the process by which plants make food. The process by which plants make food. For any questions, you can SMS me to this line, 0970 703139 0970 703139 for any questions. Okay, the process by which plants make food. If I may ask a question, by which process does plants make food? By which process does plants make food? Okay, plants make their own food. Plants make their own food through the process called photosynthesis. Plants make their own food through the process called photosynthesis. This word photosynthesis is divided into two parts. The word photo means light. The word photo means light. And the word synthesis means make. So I've talked about, I've said plants make their own food through the process called So plants make their own food through this process. So this process enables the plants to make its own food. And I've said, this word is divided into two. We have photo and synthesis. So we are saying photo means Photo means light. So the word photo means light, while the word synthesis means make. So we are saying photo means light, synthesis means make. And you have said plants make their own food through the process called photosynthesis. So for this plant to make its own food, it needs three things. For this, the plant to make its food, it means it needs three things, which is sunlight. For them to grow, it, of course, it needs sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water to make food. So we have said plants need sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water to make food. So for the plants to make food, it needs three things: sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water to make food. So the plants need three things to make food, which is sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water. Okay, the leaves, if we've seen the leaves from the green plants, the leaves from the green plant that you see around, it contains a green pigment. The leaves from the green plant, it contains a green pigment called chlorophyll. So I'm saying the leaves from the green plant contains a green pigment, which is called chlorophyll. This chlorophyll is stored in small structures. This chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. So I've said the leaves from the green plants contains a green pigment, which is chlorophyll. This same chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. So I've said the leaves from the green plants contain a green pigment, we are saying the leaves from the green plants contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. The leaves from the green plants, they have a green pigment which is called chlorophyll. This same chlorophyll is stored in small structures. This chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. This chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. So I'm saying chlorophyll is stored in small structures
called chloroplasts. So I'm saying the chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. And I've said the leaves from the green plants contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. This same chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. So these chloroplasts are stored in small structures. Okay? For any question, boys and girls, you can SMS me on the line scoring on your screen, which is 0970-7039-3139. And the GMF online is still going on. For any information, you can still call on the line scoring on your screen if you want to be part and parcel of the learning. Okay, let's continue, boys and girls. If there's any question, boys and girls, you can still SMS me on 0970-7039-3139. Okay, let's continue. We are saying the chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. Okay, we continue from there. So we are saying it's called chloroplasts in a leaf. It's stored in small structures called chloroplasts in a leaf. So this chloroplast is stored in a leaf. Okay. The chlorophyll absorbs sunlight that falls on leaves. So this chlorophyll absorbs all the sunlight that falls on the leaves and traps the energy. So it absorbs sunlight that falls on the leaves and it traps the energy. So we are saying chlorophyll absorbs all the sunlight that falls on the leaves and traps the energy. So we are saying this chlorophyll absorbs all the sunlight that falls on the leaves. So meaning all the sunlight that falls on the leaf, this chlorophyll absorbs. It takes in, to absorb is to take in and trap the energy. It traps the energy. So this process of, we have said plants make their own food through the process called photosynthesis. So this word photosynthesis can be summarized. This word can be summarized as follows. This word photosynthesis can be summarized as follows. Carbon dioxide plus water plus light is equal to glucose plus oxygen. Carbon dioxide plus water plus light is equal to glucose plus energy, or plus oxygen, sorry. So this is the way, this is the process of photosynthesis can be summarized. This process can be summarized as carbon dioxide plus water plus light is equal to glucose plus oxygen. So it's equal to carbon dioxide plus water
plus light. It's equal to glucose plus oxygen.
So we are saying this is the way photosynthesis can be summarized. The process, the whole process can be summarized by adding carbon dioxide plus you add water, light, which will give you glucose and oxygen. To give you glucose and oxygen. So if the question comes, write the equation for photosynthesis. This will be your answer. It will be carbon dioxide plus water plus light is equal to glucose plus oxygen. Boys and girls, for any question, let me check if there are any question. Okay, and if there are any question, you can still text me on the line, which is 0970-7039-3139. Okay, let's continue. So we're saying this is the process of photosynthesis. This is the way it can be summarized. Carbon dioxide plus water plus light. It's equal to glucose plus oxygen. Okay, let's continue. Let's now look at the process, the whole process of photosynthesis. I hope you have all copped this because I want to wrap now so that you look at the process now. So now, boys and girls, let's look at the process. The process of photo. We have looked at how plants make food. Now let's talk about the process of photosynthesis. The whole process. What goes on during photosynthesis? So the first is carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. The carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf through the stomata. If you talk about the atmosphere, these are layers of gases. The layers of gases around the planet. So, the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf called stomata. The stomata, these are small openings on the leaf. Any leaf has got stomata. It has got small openings. These are called the stomata. So, this carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf through the stomata. I've said stomata, these are small opening on the leaf. So you are saying, first process is that carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf through the
tomato.
So we are saying the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf through the stomata. So the carbon dioxide, I've said atmosphere, these are the layers of the gases. So this carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, it will enter a leaf through the stomata. Through the stomata. The second one, water from the roots. Water from the roots enters the leaves. Water from the roots enters the leaves. Number two, we are saying it. Water from the roots enters the leaves. Water from the roots enters the leaves. Second process of photosynthesis, we are saying water from the roots enters the leaves. The water that you pour, it enter, it goes to the roots, then it enters the leaves. So water from the root enters the leaves. You have said the first process is that carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf through the stomata. The second one, you are saying water from the roots enters the leaves. The third one that we're going to look at is the chemical reaction in leaves uses the energy. The chemical reaction from the leaves uses the energy from the sun that is trapped in chlorophyll. Remember when you talked about it, chlorophyll. We said chlorophyll absorbs all the sunlight that falls on the leaves and traps the energy. So here they're saying the chemical reaction in the leaves uses the energy from the light that is trapped in chlorophyll to produce hydrogen and oxygen. For this hydrogen and oxygen to be produced, a chemical reaction in leaves uses the energy from the light that is trapped in the chlorophyll. So we are saying a chemical reaction in the leaves use the energy, uses the energy from the sun, uses the energy from the sun that is trapped, trapped in the chlorophyll. So we are saying a chemical reaction, this chemical reaction in the leaves uses the energy from the sun that is trapped in the chlorophyll. Because here we said chlorophyll absorbs all the sunlight that falls on the leaves. So these leaves, they will now use the energy from the sun that is trapped in chlorophyll. Okay, we continue. So to produce, the reason why it traps the chlorophyll is to produce hydrogen and oxygen. So hydrogen and oxygen. So a chemical reaction in the leaves uses the energy from the sun that is trapped in the chlorophyll to produce hydrogen and oxygen. So this leaves use the energy from the sun to which is trapped. I've already explained it's trapped in chlorophyll to produce hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, the hydrogen combines with carbon dioxide. Now, this hydrogen will now combine with carbon dioxide to make glucose. So this hydrogen combines with the carbon dioxide. This hydrogen, which is produced, will now combine with the carbon dioxide to do what? To make glucose. To make glucose, which is the plant's food. So this glucose is a plant's food. So this hydrogen will combine with the carbon dioxide. The hydrogen will combine to make glucose, which is the plant's food. To make glucose, which is the plant's food. The oxygen is released in the atmosphere through the stomata. So the oxygen is now released into the atmosphere through the stomata. So we are saying the hydrogen combines with the carbon dioxide. The hydrogen combines with the carbon dioxide to make glucose. Glucose is a plant's food. Glucose is a plant's food. And then now the oxygen is released. After this is made, the oxygen is released in the atmosphere through the stomata. Through the stomata. So this is the process of photosynthesis. This is the process of photosynthesis. For any question, boys and girls, you can SMS me through this line 0970 703139, and the GMF online learning is still going on. Okay, boys and girls, we'll continue, and now we're going to look at cell respiration. I hope you have copied this. So for now, if a person asks you, how do plants make food? I'm sure you'll be able to answer through the process called photosynthesis. And I've talked about what photo means. I said photo means light, and synthesis means make. So plants need the three things to make food. I said sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water. And I've said the leaves from the green plants contain a green pigment called the chlorophyll. This chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts. And the chloroplast observes the sunlight that falls on the leaves and traps the energy. And we have talked about how the process of photosynthesis can be summarized. And I've said it can be summarized as follows: carbon dioxide plus water plus light is equal to glucose plus oxygen. And I've said glucose is a plant's food. Glucose is a plant's food. So now let's continue and let's look at cell respiration. Cell respiration. Cell respiration. So during this cell respiration, during the night, no sunlight falls on the plant. During the night, no sunlight falls on the plant. The plant uses this period to convert the glucose. So during the night, there's no sunlight which falls on the plant. So the plant uses this period. Since there's no sun that is falling on it, it uses the period to convert the glucose, which is the plant's food. Convert the glucose that is produced during the day into the different form that it can be stored. So I've said during the night. During the night.
no sunlight, falls on the plants.
So we are saying during the night, no sunlight falls on the plant. During the night, no sunlight falls on the plant. So the plant uses this period to convert the glucose that is produced during the day into a different form that can be stored. So during this time, when there is no sunlight, the plant now uses this period to convert glucose. So plants the plant uses
this period to convert.
So the plant you use now the period to convert the glucose.
So I've said during the night no sunlight falls in the plant.
So the plant will now use this period to convert the glucose, which is the plant's food, because the glucose that is produced during the day, into a different form that can be stored. So now this glucose will be converted during this time when there will be no sunlight to fall on the plants.
Okay, glucose, which is a plant, which the plant produces during photosynthesis, and we know that glucose is also produced during the process photosynthesis. So we are saying glucose, which the plant produces during photosynthesis, is a type of sugar. So this glucose is a type of sugar. Sugar dissolves in water so that plants cannot store the extra food. So we are saying this glucose, which the plant produces during photosynthesis, is a type of sugar. So glucose is a type of sugar which dissolves in water so that the plant cannot store the extra food. So this glucose, the type of sugar, it will dissolve in water so that the plant cannot store the extra food. I hope it's clear. I'm saying the glucose is a type of sugar. So this sugar would dissolve in water for the plants so that the plants cannot store any food.
Okay, I'm saying glucose
which the plant produce during a
So we are saying glucose, which the plant produces during photosynthesis, is a type of sugar. So this glucose is a type of sugar. So we are saying glucose is a type of sugar. This same sugar dissolves.
Sugar dissolves in water so that the plant cannot store any food. So we are saying, so the sugar will dissolve in water so that the plant cannot store any food. The plant uses the process of cell respiration to convert the sugar into starch. So we are saying the plant uses the process of cell respiration to convert the sugar into the starch, which does not dissolve in water. So we are saying the plant uses the process of, the plant will now use the process of cell respiration into the starch, and starch does not dissolve in water. And we are saying during the cell respiration, a small amount of carbon dioxide is released. During the process of cell respiration, a small amount of carbon dioxide is released from the leaves. So the small amount of carbon dioxide is relieved from the leaves. At night, plants take in oxygen. At night, plants take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide. I'll take note of this. We are saying it at night. At night, plants take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide. So at night, plants will take in the oxygen and release the carbon dioxide. But during the day, it's the other way around. During the day, they'll take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen. So during the night, plants will take in the oxygen and will release carbon dioxide. During the day, the plant will take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen. Okay, boys and girls, if there are any question, you can text me on the line 0970-703139. Okay, today's lesson, you looked at the process by which plants make food. The process by which plants make food. And we said the process is called photosynthesis, and it's divided into two. Photo meaning light, and synthesis meaning make. And for plants to make food, it needs three things. We said sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water. So we also talked about the leaves, which come from the green plants. They contain a green pigment called the chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is stored in small structures called chloroplasts in a leaf. So the chloroplast absorbs sunlight that falls on the leaves and traps the oxygen. And we also talked about how the process of photosynthesis can be summarized. And we said it can be summarized as follows. Carbon dioxide plus water plus light is equal to glucose plus oxygen. We also looked at the process of photosynthesis. And we said carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the leaf through the stomata. We also talked about water from the roots enters the leaves. After this, a chemical reaction in the leaves uses the energy from the light that is trapped in chlorophyll to produce hydrogen and oxygen. We also talked about, now the hydrogen, after this is produced, the hydrogen you combine with carbon dioxide to make glucose, which is the plant's food. The energy is released into the atmosphere through the stomata. And we said at night, plants take in oxygen and release the carbon dioxide. During the day, the plants take in carbon dioxide and release the oxygen. It's the other way round. For any question, boys and girls, this is a grade 6 class with me, Mrs. Annie Kantoma. can SMS me using this line 0970-7039-3139. At this time, let me just check if there are any questions. There's a question, what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process by which plants make their own food. Photosynthesis is a process by which plants make their own food. Okay, this ends lesson for today. See you next time when you have integrated science. Thank you.
And these are examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the life.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.